I'm sure by now most of you are familiar with the metaphor by Scott Adams, that people have been watching two different movies on the same screen. In short, this simply means that two groups on opposite sides of the ideological divide are watching the same events play out with different narrative perceptions of what is going on. Red people who follow red sources get their worldview reflected back at them, while blue people who follow blue sources get their biases confirmed instead. We are also by now familiar with the idea of an echo chamber, that is, that most people, most of the time, talk to people in their own ideological bubble. But even across these echo chambers, you'll note this middle space in which there is some crossover, and in which everyone agrees, at the very least, that an event occurred. Let's say, in this case, that a tree fell over and caused some damage. However, in the past few weeks, something strange has happened, which is that the two sides are no longer even watching the same screen, which is to say that the basic facts of what happened, the event, so to speak, are not agreed upon. Now, if only red sources cover the fact that blue punches red, a person on the blue side sees only a version of events in which red punches blue. Now let's pretend someone from the red side tries, for example, to cross or invade the blue echo chamber, and quite literally insert clips of blue punching red in his otherwise pristine blue Twitter or Facebook feed. The person from the red side is ensuring that the person from the blue side sees these things with their own eyes. But does it matter? Well, because the person from the blue side has been well trained to think like a blue, the first thing they look for is whether the source can be trusted. But oh no, the person from the red side has provided a clip that is tainted by the fact that it comes from a red source. Red bad, blue good. Need blue source to verify. Our person from the blue side will not believe what they are seeing with their own eyes unless it has been verified by another blue. But when our intrepid truth warrior goes to consult all his usual sources, the story is completely missing. There is no record anywhere to be found of blue punching red. And so the person from the blue side somehow explains away the evidence he has seen with his own eyes as being faked or fraudulent or spun in some way, because red bad, blue good. The event was that red punched blue, and that is all. Now, I would suggest that when the events in question are of great significance, this is quite a serious problem. It's been quite remarkable to see this in action during a time when everyone has a smartphone, which can instantly record and upload anything, and in which clips can go viral in seconds. We now live in a time when some people won't even admit the evidence of their own eyes. I've even seen some reports where reporters are right there on location and in their descriptions denying the very things that they are witnessing. The fabric of reality itself seems to be dissolving. I'm reminded of a play called Rhinoceros by Eugene Ionesco, in which a man in a village witnesses everyone around him, one by one, turning into a rhinoceros. When he's the only one left, he starts to doubt his own existence. And then he tries to turn himself into a rhinoceros too. He struggles, but he fails. And then, in the end, vows to fight the rhinoceroses and exclaims, "I'm not capitulating." Maybe things aren't as bad as that yet. So what do we do? How is it possible to get through to anyone who will only accept blue sources when said blue sources will not report an event? How do you speak to someone who, for all intents and purposes, has become a rhinoceros? I don't know the answer, but I'm asking you, dear viewer, to make some suggestions in the comments. These could be your own friends, family members, loved ones, your neighbours. What strategies can we utilise to confront them with reality in terms they might accept and understand? This strikes me as a vital challenge right now, because soon, and sooner than we anticipate, it will be too late. Now get out.